Hi, I'm Dave, KG0ZZ. I've been a licensed radio amateur since 1993, and my favorite part of the hobby is building antennas. And welcome. Thank you for joining me. In my last video, I built a 10-meter ground plane antenna, and it was just a simple ground-mounted vertical antenna that really came out very nice. It was very broadbanded, and it did perform quite well. What I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to take some parts from the 10-meter antenna, and I'm going to add a few more parts, and I'm going to try to turn that antenna into a multi-band trap vertical antenna. I was surfing the internet a while back, and I came across an antenna design that was done by NU3E, and what he had done was built a multi-band trap dipole antenna that was small enough that he could fit inside of his attic. Now, it was really meant to be an indoor stealth antenna, and it was just a wire dipole antenna, and it was a pretty neat design. I've included a link to his project on my website if you'd like to see it. What I've decided to do is try to take his idea for just two of the traps, the 10 and 15 meter traps, and I'm going to see if I can build a multi-band trap vertical antenna that will work 10, 15, and 20 meters. This is the mounting bracket off of the 10 meter antenna, and I'm going to use that on this antenna also. But since this antenna is going to be larger and taller, I'm going to use some larger aluminum tubing and some larger PVC pipe. On the last one, I used 3/4 inch. This time I've got a scrap piece of, this is the gray PVC pipe. I'm going to need to cut off a piece about 10 inches long to fit on here. But this is a 1 inch PVC pipe. And I'm going to fit a piece of 1-inch aluminum tubing down into the PVC pipe for the base of the antenna. And so the sizes here, I've got, these are 4-foot lengths, and here I've got three of them put together. This is going to be the base of the antenna. This is 1-inch, 7/8, and 3/4-inch aluminum tubing. And so that'll be the bottom part, the 10-meter section of the antenna. This is a piece of 5/8 inch aluminum tubing, and I'm going to use that to build the traps. The traps are made out of coaxial cable, and I've got the rest of the parts here for those. Let's just go ahead and go through those. I'm using RG58 coaxial cable for the traps, and what I'm going to do is wind the coaxial cable around some PVC pipe couplers. And so I've got two 1-inch PVC pipe couplers, and I've got four reducers that go from 3/4 inch to 1/2 inch. And then I also have some scrap pieces of PVC pipe. These are left over from another project. Some 3/4 inch pipe and some 1/2 inch pipe here just to fit these pieces together with. Let's see, I've got a hose clamp here. This is going to go on the end of my PVC pipe. A couple of more hose clamps. Those are going to go on the 15 meter section. 15 meters, that's what this is for. I've got another scrap piece of 3/4 inch tubing, and I'll have to cut a short section out of this to make the 15 meter section of the antenna. For the top part of the antenna, the 20 meter section of the antenna, I don't know exactly how long the length is going to be yet. I won't know until I start tuning and adjusting the antenna. Starting off here, I've got a piece of 3/4 inch PVC or 3/4 inch aluminum tubing and a piece of 5/8 aluminum tubing, and so I've got four and a half feet to work with here so far, about a meter and a half, and let's see what else. Feed line the same as in the last antenna, except for this time I've put a number 6 ring connector on here. Hardware, I've got five number 6 sheet metal screws. These are 1/2 inch long. Can't use anything longer than 1/2 inch. These are internal tooth lock washers. There's five of them here. I'll be using one screw and one lock washer to attach my feed line, and these others to attach the trap to the aluminum tubing. Also using some number 6 ring connectors. I've got 2 blue and 2 red. I've got 4 machine screws. These are 1 inch long. These will fit through the aluminum tubing and through a piece of half inch PVC pipe. Then I've got 4 split washers and 4 number 6 nuts to go along with the machine screws. Here's a 5/8 inch cap putting on the very top section of tubing. And here, these are some large ring connectors. This time I'm going to go ahead and put ring connectors on my radials. I only have 2 here, but I'm going to need 6 of those. I'm beginning to run a little bit short of wire. I'm reusing a 14 gauge solid copper wire, and I'm just going to make 2 radials per band just to test this antenna out. If you like, you can put 3 or 4 radials on the antenna. And then I'm also going to use the landscaping staples to tack the wire down to the ground with here.
The mounting plate is ready to go. I made this in the last video. And the piece of PVC pipe is going to go on the 2 inside U-bolts on this side of it. So the first thing, I'm going to build it from the working from the bottom of the antenna up towards the top. And so the first thing is to get my piece of PVC pipe ready to go. I'm going to measure down about 2 inches. Just draw a line across there. I've got my safety glasses, I've got my dust mask, I've got my Dremel tool. And the Dremel tool has a fresh battery pack, and it has a new reinforced cutoff wheel on it. It over and do the other side. Mark it. Pipe all notched out. Let me just take a hose clamp on it. And stick the largest piece of aluminum tubing in it. Put this down here like this. And leave about an inch or a little more than an inch sticking out there. And go ahead and tighten down the hose clamp. Let's start off with a 3/4 inch PVC pipe coupler. And this first trap, the 10 meter trap, is made with 4 turns of RG58U coaxial cable. So I've cut a length here that is 26 1/4 inches long, or about 66.7 centimeters. And what I'm going to do is strip 3 inches of insulation off each side so that in the middle of this, I leave 20 1/4 inches with the outer jacket intact. And so when I get down there, 20 1/4 inches, that would be about 51.4 centimeters. Just take... Take a little piece of tape, put it across there just to mark it for the holes. Set it over here on the edge of my cutting board. And just try to take the cap off of that. Just draw a nice neat little line across there. Okay, I'll try to net wrap 4 turns of cable around this. Let's turn my form over here so I can find my end of my cable. Try to kind of center that. see. One, two, three, four turns. Let's put a little mark. Right in there. I don't know if I can mark the other side or not. May have to drill a hole in it first. A little extra tape on the sides. I stuck it in the vise. Let's take an awl. If I can mark a spot for a hole. And I think just for accuracy, I'm going to start off with a 1/8 inch drill bit. I could go to a larger one, but start with a smaller one. 3/16 inch is too small. 7/32 might be a little bit large, so I'm going to use a 13/64 inch drill bit. Let's see if the cable will fit in that. A little snug. Cable, the end of the cable is not very neat either. There we go. Let's go ahead and take the cable and wrap four turns around it and see what it looks like here. Two. That's one turn. It's three turns. Four turns. Kind of straighten out the coil a little bit. Let's see. So we start here. We've got 1, 2, 3. This is the fourth. So the hole needs to be right in the center of the last cable, of the last turn. Okay, back to the 1/8 inch drill bit. Now the 13/64. Cable's going to go on the other side. Yeah, okay. Now I'll get the coaxial cable ready to go. I've got 3 inches of insulation stripped off the ends of the coaxial cable, and I've got the center and the shield separated. So let's try and see if we can get this in here. Put these down in the hole. Pulling off the side. And I think I'm just going to leave just barely 1/4 inch of wire on the inside there. Not much more than that. I'll give this a nice turn up there. See if we can get 4 turns on this. Looks like my hole's a little bit snug. Hopefully I can get this in here. Okay. I'll push it down as far as I can. Through there. A little bit of wire bunched up on the side. There we go. Now, let's find a pair of pliers. I get that started in the hole. There we go. Got it started. Get that press down in there. I think I want to push a little more back through the other side. Kind of tighten this up a little bit. I can push that down in there. Keep tightening it up. That's plenty of cable on that side. Let's try the other side here. Just kind of press on that a little bit. Now all I have to do is just solder the ends of the wire. And I think next, choose one end to connect. I think I will save about 1 inch of insulation off of one of these center leads. Just go ahead and mark it. I'm going to take the wire and I'm going to try to stuff that down inside of there. And run that through the other side. Kind of fold that over, move this other lead out of the way, and then take those two leads and twist those two together. Give that a moment to heat up. Try to snip that off. Okay, we're good. So here is the MFJ antenna analyzer along with the MFJ grid dip meter adapter. And on this trap, I need to make sure that this cable is pressed in all the way, nice and tight, nice and snug. And I've had to kind of bend the wires here on the inside to try to get this to fit. It's kind of a tight fit. Get that slipped on there. Now we'll see where this is resonant at. All right, instead of watching the SWRs up here, which it says greater than 25, watch the meter down here, because this what we're looking for is a dip in the SWR meter here, and that'll let us know where the resonant frequency is at. And it dipped 28, 590, 588, 590, 600. It's not too bad.
All right, you notice the cable, if you can see, this is kind of spread apart, and I'm going to push the cable together, make it look a little neater, but I may not want to stay. I may have to use a little bit of tape. Just kind of rearrange the cable. Now we're at 28.3. Doesn't look like it's quite as resonant. Play with the cable a little bit more. I'm dipping at 28.4. I have put two pieces of masking tape on the trap to try to hold this coaxial cable in place. And I'm checking this on the meter here. And I am dipping down to about 28.430. And I'm seeing 1.2 on the meter. So if I've done this correctly, if I've got this trap tuned the way that it should be, at about 28.420 is probably where we should see about the best impedance match on the antenna also as far as the 10 meter band. And so hopefully I won't disturb this cable. And I think I'm going to try to use some hot glue and try to glue the coils in place here so that they don't move around. So let's take a little bit of hot glue. Let's see if I can get it across here. Just kind of want to put a bridge across it and kind of hold the cables in place and maybe put a little bit in between the cables. Give that a moment and I'll turn this and run another bead across it. Come right around on this other cable. Put some on it.